Alright, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome back to English Conversation Class. Today, Thursday, November 4th, 2021, with students from Bung Hatta University, English Department, Japanese Department, and Bahasa Indonesia Department. We will continue the discussion about marriage. Okay, so the list of vocabulary that we see in this picture shows different ways of understanding what marriage is. The first one, we see this word, anniversary. Anybody knows what is anniversary? Apa itu anniversary?
Hari jadi, sir.
Anniversary, hari jadi. Boleh, hari jadi. Sebenarnya kalau hari jadi itu konteksnya pacaran, itu hari jadi. Anniversary means that
when you
memperingati, it's anniversary annually ya. Anniversary ada any gitu. Jadi mengingat tanggal menikah seperti itu ya. Excuse me. And then we have number two, celebration. Celebration ini biasanya setelah wedding ada celebration. Close-knit family. Close-knit family sama hampir sama dengan nuclear family, but it's the closest one with a couple. And then commitment, this is important. Number four, when you come to marriage, this is important, commitment, not just love. Even though you have love, but if you do not have commitment, it's not going to be okay. Commitment and committed, companion and companionship. So they are in companion. It's not friend. Friend dengan companion beda ya. Kalau friend you meet on campus, classmates, they're your friend. But companion means someone who live with you.
Pendamping, sir.
Yes, pendamping. Good, perfect. This companion. Jadi bukan, jangan bilang best friend ya. No, it's different. Friend and best friend. It's different ways of understanding that. And apakah ada kosakata yang tidak tahu? Do you have any words that you don't know?
Corporate itu, sir.
Apa kok? Number 8.
Cooperate.
Yes.
Oh, cooperate. Cooperate ini dasar katanya dari operate. Ini operate berarti melaksanakan sesuatu, dan cooperate artinya ini kalau saya bawakan ke sini, ini ada dua pena. Pertama satu pena hitam dan pena biru. Jadi mereka ini digunakan ganti-gantian, itu cooperate, kerjasama artinya ya, cooperate. Cooperation, cooperation itu perusahaan, berarti mereka orang-orang bekerja sama dalam itu. Kooperatif berarti sifat, sifatnya bisa bekerja sama. Good times, hard times. Nah, jadi good times suka, senang. Hard time itu ketika sulit. Jadi when you one day when you get married, you need to remember that life is not always about good times. We need hard times in order to respect good times. Betul nggak kira-kira? Karena ada gula, maka kita tahu pahit. Karena ada obat, kita jadi suka yang manis. Tapi nggak semua yang manis itu bagus. Kemudian, kalau yang number 13, do you know what is that?
Tagihan.
Oke.
Iya, pembayaran tagihan.
It's a pay bills that you need to pay the bills. Look at them. They live in their house for the first time. So maybe they built a new home like this, new room. Dindingnya masih bercak-bercak begitu. Kemudian baru dicat. Yeah, it's okay because they are newlywed couple. Kalau di luar negeri sana ya, kalau rata-rata if you could get married, it means you are considered menengah ke atas. ya, kalau sudah married itu menengah ke atas. Nah, kemudian you have a certain responsibility with the spouse and with the children. Ini spouse. Spouse ini artinya your
pasangan.
Ya, pasangan. And then tolerate. Ini penting. Tolerate ini sebenarnya kalau
toleransi,
tapi sekarang akhir-akhir ini saya lihat toleransi ini maknanya jadi melebar begitu. Jadi toleransi ini
saling
untuk
mengerti, so.
Saling mengerti untuk hal-hal yang bisa kita excuse itu terjadi, itu toleransi. Jadi toleransi adalah sikap kita yang bisa kita berikan excuse tentang sesuatu itu terjadi. Contoh misalnya, for example, kalian lagi duduk di depan televisi nonton, terus baru pulang adik misalnya, atau teman yang sekos misalnya, ya. Terus dia buru-buru ke dalam. Karena buru-buru, tersenggol a glass on the table, and then suddenly the glass fell to the floor and it cracked. And it is broken into pieces, pecah misalnya. Dan bunyi gelas pecah gimana? Berisik ya. Itu butuh tolerate namanya. Karena itu ketidaksengajaan. Nah, kalau misalnya perbuatan kriminal, apakah bisa kita toleransi?
Kalau merugikan diri sendiri nggak apa-apa, Sar. Tapi kalau merugikan orang lain.
Ya. Kalau merugikan orang lainnya, ya, of course we have to punish that person who committed the crime. But before we give the punishment, we need to know the motive behind that criminal action. So that it becomes a learning process for the rest. Nah, jangan seperti ini, karena tidak punya uang, terus rumah orang dirampok misalnya. That's wrong. Itu juga salah. So that's why we need to help each other. Yeah, we need to help each other regardless of your age, your religion, or where do you live, whether you are a man or woman. We need to help each other. And then that's what we call support. It's a support. We need to support together and then work together. Nah, seperti sebuah kapal, you need to work together. So you can't live alone by yourself and then handling everything. So it's work together. So they need to work together. Yeah. Oh, I like this. What is this? What do you call this one?
Which one, sir?
This picture. Look at this picture.
Birthday cake.
Birthday cake?
No.
Anniversary cake.
Wedding cake.
Wedding cake.
Yeah, wedding cake.
It's a wedding cake. Yeah. So it's a very delicious. It's very nice and very tasty. Kalau bisa biasanya ya kulturnya gini. Kalau yang masih single, itu akan diberikan kue yang paling atas oleh si bride atau oleh groom. Kepada, kalau groom akan berikan ke teman yang laki-laki biar cepat juga segera merit. Kalau yang bride
lempar
juga
bunga,
akan,
sir.
Atau bunga dilempar ke belakang. Itu kan kultur orang barat itu ya. Lempar ke belakang, nanti teriak-teriak temannya ngambil. I want to get married too. Kan? Nah, so it's really fun to have this kind of situation, but remember about the concept of good times and hard times. We need to appreciate good times because sometimes we can come to hard times. So the relationship is tested in the hard times, not in the good times. The same thing with friendship. Pertemanan, hubungan, keluarga, semuanya dinilai bukan pada saat semuanya baik, tapi pada saat sulit. Itu penilaiannya. Tampak, ya? Not in the good times. Alright, so question number 3. What are the bad times? Apa contohnya kira-kira? Bad times. Do you know what is the sample? Bad time? This?
Saat tidak punya uang, sir.
Okay, that's bad times. What about this one?
When you are get sick.
Mm-hmm. Good. When the child is getting sick and then both couple need to be responsible and taking care of the child. This one, well, I have experienced this when saya pernah mengalami ini waktu anak saya usia 4 bulan masuk rumah sakit. Itu ya, jadi beberapa harus komitmen tadi itu. So it's not just about you and your feeling, it's also about your family. Okay, we don't need to be selfish or self-centered. We need to share the time and work together. Okay, so this is, yes.
What is the difference between selfish and self-love?
Ah, okay, good question. Selfish is actually when you put yourself above others, where actually you can do kindness to them. You put yourself above others. Jadi kalau selfish itu kita meletakkan diri kita di atas orang lain, yang sebenarnya pada waktu itu kita bisa membantu, kita bisa menolong, kita bisa berbagi, kita bisa menunjukkan jalan, tapi kita memilih untuk tidak. Karena kita takut rugi, karena kita takut penilaian orang. Nah, itu selfish. Selfish namanya. So you put yourself above others too high, sampai akhirnya you forget where you stand on the ground. Jadi yang apa itu, put your feet on the ground, itu idiomatic, maknanya yes, berjalanlah seperti orang kebanyakan gitu. Put your dream high, letakkan cita-cita tinggi setinggi langit, tapi hati serendah mutiara di dasar laut, seperti itu. So self love is that. Self love misalnya, karena apa ya, saya pernah diskusi sama seseorang di Twitter, she said about love is universal thing. Lalu saya tanya gini, imagine if I slap you for no reason, slap, tampar, for no reason, will you still love me? Itu saya tanya ke dia kan, di Twitter. And she said, I love you, but you slap me. I will still love you, but I will not accept your behavior to me. Paham nggak maksudnya itu kalimatnya? Ya, jadi love-nya tetap ada, tapi yang behavior-nya tidak terima. Gitu ya. Jadi jangan lu gue over. jangan begitu. Ngambek terus over. No. It's self-love is when you actually accept everything comes to you and part of you. At the same time, you share it to people. You know what I mean? So you feel your heart is full, because your heart is full, you share it to others. Karena kita, hati kita full, penuh, happy, kita bahagia, kita share ke orang-orang sekitar. Nah, kalau selfish, scared, takut. Jadi di ibarat ini ya. ini ibaratnya love ditutupnya, this is only for me. Tidak boleh ada yang melihat. That's selfish. Just be open up. Okay, so it's very good question, Dian Hadini. It's very nice, interesting. Now we come to the next one. This is about marriage. It's not easy. Ask your mom. You can ask your dad. What does it mean to get married? It's not like in movies. It's not easy, but it is everlasting. It is the core of human beings to build this kind of institution, right? The next one, we talk about having a baby, of course. Having a baby. Now, it's interesting. One day when you have a baby, you will change your mind what it means with who you are, and then how do you come today here as a human. And you will see your mother as an important figure and your father as an important figure as well. Without them, you won't be here, right? So it's very interesting. Now, let's see this list of vocabulary, 1 until 26. Okay, who wants to read this? Anggun tadi sudah. Raffi Pratama. Echa tadi sudah. Okay, Raffi Pratama. Jeffrey. Yang ketiga siapa? Zaki. Oke, silakan.
Amnion sentences, baby bottle, baby shower, bottle feed, wedding experiences, car seat, change the diaper, crib.
Mm-hmm. Oke, okay, good. Ini apa tadi ini? Number one, Raffi?
Amnion sentences.
Oke, okay. Amniocentesis. Amniocentesis.
Yes.
Oke, okay, good. Alright, silakan Jeffrey.
Delivery room, expectant parents, father-to-be, fetus, give birth, infant, in labor, midwife.
Mm, okay, good. All right, next one, number 18 to 26. Zaki, silakan.
Mother-to-be, natural childbirth, obstetrician, pacifier, playpen, pregnant, stroller, ultrasound, walker.
Okay, good. Perfect. Ini tadi apa, Zaki, number 2021?
Pacifier.
Okay, pacifier. Pacifier. Okay, pacifier. All right, now this list of vocabulary related to having a baby. So, you were a baby, I was a baby, now you are not a baby anymore. Itu sebabnya kalau dalam bahasa Inggris, mereka suka bilang, hi baby, come here. Baby maksudnya menunjukkan rasa sayang gitu ya sama seseorang. Hi baby, you are my baby, come here. Nah, seperti itu ekspresinya. So, let's say amniocentesis, this is related to when you give birth, ini give birth. Mana tadi kosakatanya give birth, ini melahirkan, delivering a baby or give birth, okay, give birth. Kemudian yang lahir ini namanya infant, yang dalam perut adalah fetus, and then midwife ini sudah melahirkan, midwife. Natural childbirth, it means when you were born naturally without any preparation procedure. Tanpa ada apa prosedur operasi. It's very natural. The mother is safe and the baby is safe. And obstetricians, when it is taken care by the doctor for child and babies. Pregnant, you know this already. Ada nggak yang tidak tahu?
Fetus itu apa, sir?
Okay. Fetus ini yang ada di dalam perut, yang masih dalam perut itu disebut dengan fetus. Makanya kalau perempuan yang sekarang lagi viral itu di Eropa, di beberapa negara, kayak di Prancis misalnya, dibilang menuntut hak wanita untuk melakukan abortion. So now I'm asking you, what do you think about women want to do abortion?
Sama aja kayak membunuh,
sir. Yes, mm-hmm. Okay.
Enggak setuju.
Haknya dia, sir.
Kenapa,
tapi
Fiona?
Tapi kalau itu hasil dari bukan yang dia inginkan, gimana, sir?
That's the question.
Mm-hmm. Ya, misalnya kayak dia tuh dapat itu dari rap culture, kayak pengkosaan atau gimana sir.
Okay, I understand that.
Bukan sesuatu yang dia inginkan.
So we talk about having abortion or killing the fetus, we need to know the reason behind why the woman wants to do abortion. First of all, we need to see behind that. Women need to know that when they do abortion, it will impact to their womb. Akan mempengaruhi kepada rahim mereka. That's one thing, yeah. And then the second of all, when women decide to do abortion, maybe it relates to her psychological being or inner well-being, kesehatan mentalnya. Mungkin maybe ya, dari beberapa video yang saya lihat tentang korban rape, culture seperti itu, she would say she doesn't accept that kind of the fetus. And then my question is, biologically speaking, is it possible for someone be pregnant just for one time? You know, ideally with being raped and then suddenly she become pregnant. That's the big question. Usually, not often. That's not often the case. Okay, thank you, Lavoni. Midwife, a woman skilled in aiding the delivery of babies. Good. Midwife berarti dokter yang membantu persalinan ya. Okay, thank you. Jadi kalau misalnya tadi we talk about abortion, kembali kepada motif why the woman wants to do it. Kalau dia sudah 2 bulan ya, that's not going to be okay for her wombs if she wants to be a mother one day. And kembali, we go back, how could this person meet her? Usually in the name of law, korban tidak pernah jauh dari pelaku. Usually it's very usual, karena memang dulu ada mahasiswi saya yang dia ditemukan meninggal setelah diperkosa, dan itu wilayahnya ada di Padang juga ya, saya di dekat bypass ke atas itu, di Kuranji ke atas. So she met this guy and then she was raped, and then suddenly yang laki-lakinya baru nyadar, si perempuannya ini menolak, tidak mau menerima, dan dia begini, you know what I mean, ketika begini ya. Kalau saya paham kenapa wanita seperti ini, artinya dia mendefend, membela diri mereka, I understand that. And dia panik, kalap, dan akhirnya mengambil linggis, and ya, terjadilah berikutnya gitu ya, yang akhirnya menjadi. Nah, kalau kita, when we try to understand that kind of situation, actually this is about access. It about access kepada seorang perempuan dan juga akses yang diterima oleh seorang laki-laki. When you open the access, there will be something come to you. So that's the point. That's the rape come. Perkosaan itu muncul karena itu. So it's a very, both sides are guilty. Kedua-duanya juga salah. Yang laki-laki tidak tahu peran dan fungsinya. Perempuan juga, you need to control something within yourself. But again, the question is,
excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why is it Walker, sir?
Apa?
Walker,
this one?
Yeah.
Okay, good question. Walker means this one. This, ini. Groba ini. Ini baby Walker namanya ini. This is a Walker. Okay.
Sir, kalau... Yes? Mother to be,
okay. Mother to be means mereka ini. Nah, ini. So mother to be means a woman who is already pregnant, and father to be is a man or a husband who has his wife has been pregnant. Jadi menunggu bayi lagi. Jadi mother to be, father to be. Okay.
Istilah dari calon orang tua.
Good. Good, calon ibu. Kalau mother to be, calon ibu. Father to be, calon ayah, ini istilahnya ya. Seorang perempuan yang sudah bersuami dan sedang hamil. Okay. Alright, so what else?
Playpen apa, sir?
Playpen.
Playpen.
Anyone wants to help? What is playpen?
Box baby, sir.
Mm-hmm. Kalau box baby yang ada di dalam ini. Ini box baby, keranjang bayi di sini. Ini box baby, playpen. Anyone wants to answer the question? Playpen. Let me see. It's a sort of
permainan
ya, permainan untuk anak-anak. Let me check what is the image of the playpen actually. Okay, it is. What about infant? Apa bedanya infant dengan fetus? Mm-hmm.
Fetus tuh kayak masih kayak janin gitu barusan.
Ya, betul. Kalau infant?
Kalau infant udah bayi.
Sudah bayi. Jadi bayi.
Sudah lahir ya.
It's udah amazing. Sudah terbentuk jenis kelaminnya, Sir.
Iya.
Oh, oke. Okay. Nah, jadi kalau di sini dari kamus Cambridge apa? Webster, playpen means portable, usually collapsible enclosure in which a baby or young child may play. Jadi tempat di mana anak-anak bisa bermain. Nah, di sini playpen. It's nih, di sini dia. Playpen. Kalau ini walker. Kemudian ini ada tempat perlengkapan bayi. It's very sangat komplit ya. Berbeda dengan kalau kalian menonton acara Everyone Loves Babies, itu kan ditemukan bayi-bayi itu dibesarkan dengan cara-cara berbeda. Ada bayi yang pakai coklat lumpur itu ke badannya sebagai minyak in Africa, for example. Okay, so the last one, this is for next week. Alright, untuk minggu depan, we will be talking about this one, subtopics, growing up, parenting, after school, divorce, and growing old. Five subtopics. After, we need to go back to this one. I'm interesting about, hold on. Because you are millennials, generasi millennial. This is very, very interesting conversation about this topic today. Karena saya juga memperhatikan ada kayak apa kekerasan di sekolah, kemudian di beberapa pendidikan tempat pendidikan tinggi juga terjadi. Kemarin juga viral video senior yang berbuat kasar pada junior. What do you think actually? What is the main problem?
I think maybe they are have a trauma and they impact. Kayak mereka tuh punya permasalahan di tempat lain, jadi mereka buatkan di sekolah gitu.
Okay, maybe. Yeah, ada traumatic experience juga, ya, yeah, that's something like that.
Lingkungan.
Lingkungan juga, environment. And have you ever heard about abuse?
Yes, sir.
Kalau kalian suka ini nonton acara seperti saya nggak nyebut acaranya, ada di YouTube itu Criminal Investigation, kemudian acara-acara seperti apa, pokoknya berkaitan kriminal. Ini ada istilahnya, bentar ini saya ketik, ini kata-katanya. Nah, this one, investigation. Okay. Investigation oleh FBI or CIA, itu ada beberapa kasus, misalnya di Amerika Serikat itu. Nah, setelah ditangkap pelakunya, diinterview oleh pihak kepolisian, dibilang karena dia suka pada korban. Nah, sekarang saya tanya, why would that kind of thing happen? Saya mengajak berpikir abstrak, memang agak sulit, but we try. Why would that kind of thing happen?
Because they don't have empathy.
Mm-hmm. No empathy.
Yes, I think like a psychopath or a sociopath something.
Yeah, it may relate to that one because ada kasus Jeffrey. Let me see in the websites whether I can show it to you. The murder case in the USA, for example. Okay.
Like Ted Bundy, sir. Ted Bundy.
Siapa?
Do you know Ted Bundy?
Ted Bundy? No. I don't know them. I don't know him. Why? Who is he? Siapa dia itu? Who is he? Okay, now this is, I show you the website. For example, this is the murder case in the USA. 1947, Black Dahlia, best known unsolved. 22 tahun, Elizabeth Short, tubuhnya yang dimutilasi dan dipotong berbagai bagian ditemukan di Los Angeles oleh seorang ibu yang sedang berjalan dengan anaknya. Tahun 1947. So, there are many, banyak, so many cases. You can see, it's very interesting, out of curiosity, yeah. Jadi, when you try to practice English, not just speaking English, but also read a lot, so that you grow your curiosity, you have a sense of wanting to know more. So in that way, you build up your knowledge. Jadi, ada namanya knowledge, ada science, ada expertise. Kalau knowledge itu pengetahuan, kalau ilmu, the science, kalau dia expertise, pakar dia. So read more, bahkan ada, it's very interesting about this one. Why would that kind of thing happen? So I stop share at this point. I go back to the presentation. When you try to communicate in English, what is the first thing that you need to have in mind? Ini bayangkan seolah kita ujian akhir seperti ini. When you want to speak in English and converse with someone in English, what is the first thing that you have in mind?
How are you?
Mm-hmm. Okay. How are you? What else?
What things that make you happy and sad?
Mm-hmm. What thing that makes you happy and sad? Is it personal question? Can we allow someone ask that to us? Remember. Bukan. Maksudnya gini. Kalau ada pertanyaan yang kita sendiri merasa sensitif untuk kita jawab, berarti pertanyaan yang sama juga jangan ditanyakan ke orang lain. Mungkin orang lain juga merasakan hal yang sama. So that's the, pernah dengar istilah ini? Hold on, this one. The law of attraction. Pernah dengar?
Pernah, sir, tapi nggak tahu apa artinya.
The law of attraction. Nah, ini dia. The law of attraction. It means this semacam hukum fisika. What you give is what you get. If you give question, you will get answer. Sama seperti itu. If you say how are you, you will get respond. Nggak dijawab pun berarti itu responnya kan. Itu contohnya sederhananya ya. Kalau ngetuk pintu, law of attraction-nya ketuk pintu. Hasilnya apa? Pintu dibuka atau pintu tidak dibuka. It's sort of like that. Okay, so the other thing is about this one, relationship. What do you have in mind about relationship? I have a book in here with me. Judul bukunya ini, Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus. Ini bukunya, ini teksnya berbahasa Inggris oleh penulisnya ini, John Gray. Jadi, it talks about the differences between women and men, psychologically, ada halaman 133, it's very interesting. Now, we have women need to receive, okay, this is English conversation class, so we need talking in conversation. Women need to receive, ada 6 hal yang women need to receive. The first one is caring. 2, understanding. 3, respect. 4, devotion. 5, validation. And 6, reassurance. Dengan kata lain, wanita itu memerlukan 1, perhatian. 2, pemahaman. Yang ketiga, respect. Dihargai ya, merasa dihargai. 4, devotion, kesetiaan. 5, validation, disetujui apa yang dia bilang. Yang keenam, reassurance. Reassurance ini kasih tahu lagi gitu. Itu wanita. I don't know, you can argue if it is not true, okay? Nah, sekarang kita masuk ke sisi lainnya yang penghuni planet Mars alias men. Seperti si Jeffrey itu men ya. Nah, kalau man membutuhkan satu, trust, kepercayaan, trust. Yang kedua, acceptance, penerimaan. Dia mau diterima gitu loh. Yang ketiga, appreciation. Appreciation, dihargai apa yang dia kerjakan. Yang keempat, admiration. Pria itu mau disanjung, mau dipuji, mau diangkat-angkat ininya, harga dirinya gitu. Kemudian kelima, approval. Approval ini setuju. Setuju, setuju gitu. Dia senang itu. Yang keenam, encouragement. Encouragement, senang diberi support. Ayo, semangat, semangat. Nah, seperti itu. Nah, what do you think about that? It's a very interesting, right? Anyone want to say something? Woman
I just think that stereotypical.
Perhaps this is a sort of a stereotypical. Kalau boleh ditambahkan, do you have something to add? Ada yang mau ditambahkan? From woman, from man. Karena sir, yes, silakan Jeffrey.
Bukannya wanita yang senang dipuji, sir?
Di sini maksudnya
cowok lebih senang.
Kalau sebenarnya di sini
yang sama suka dipuji, sir.
Karena yang dipuji ini bukan misalnya oh wajah kamu glowing, bukan gitu, bukan. Bukan. Kalau perempuan suka yang begitu.
Paham.
Ya, kalau yang dipuji ini misalnya wah Jeffrey bisa ya 2 jam selesai satu tulisan, nah gitu. Jadi misalnya dia sedang melakukan sesuatu, misalnya menggambar atau main bola atau pokoknya
itu
doing something.
Itu lebih menghargai nggak sih?
Nah iya itu disebut di sini dalam bahasa Inggrisnya appreciation, diapresiasi yang dilakukan. Yeah. Sekalipun mungkin misalnya ada yang bola-bola misalnya, wah bagus sekali ya, weh terima kasih ya, keren gitu. Dia suka begitu. Nah, kalau perempuan beda, perempuan itu lebih suka ke ininya ke respect. Wah, saya salut sama kamu. Bisa ya dalam sibuk begini selesai semuanya. Nah, dia senang begitu kan. Nah, begitu. So, itu seninya. This is very interesting. Itu makanya kenapa kadang-kadang ketika woman and man communicate dalam bahasa yang sama tapi makna kadang-kadang berbeda. Meaning is different. Kalau misalnya dia bertanya, what do you think? Menurut kamu gimana? Kalau laki-laki dijawab aja satu kata, dia fine. Misalnya, what do you think? Oh, that's good. It's okay. Wow, great. Selesai kalau bagi men. Tapi bagi woman, itu jadi masalah. It's a problem. Kalau misalnya dibilang, dia misalnya beli baju ya, new clothes. What do you think? Kita jawab, nice, very nice. Maksud kita memang very nice, tapi bagi dia itu problem. Nice-nya gimana? Harus detail ke bawah. Nah, that's a very interesting. Ini salah satu. Jadi, read more, banyak baca. And don't forget, after you read, talk with your friend, try to speak in English and discuss with that. That's the only way for you to get English to be your language. Seperti itu, satu-satunya ya. Okay? All right, less than 1 minute. I will close this class. And I'll see you again next week, meeting 8. Thank you for joining with me. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Absen jangan lupa diisi ya. Absen.
Yes, sir.
Bye-bye.